So captains, let's talk about Lufthansa. So Lufthansa is one of those airlines which has a great reputation within the aviation community. Founded all the way back in 1953, it's fair to say that Lufthansa has contributed considerably to the aviation community. Being one of the founding members of Star Alliance with a considerably large fleet, it's up to you whether you believe that the reputation of Lufthansa is actually justified. So I was actually given the opportunity to fly with the airline when I visited Hong Kong, and the flights that I actually took were from Manchester to Munich on the A319 and then the A380 from Munich to Hong Kong. Now, if I'm being honest with you guys, I felt like the service on Lufthansa was mediocre. The hype wasn't actually justified compared to the service that we actually received. Now, I'm comparing my Lufthansa A380 experience to the experience of Emirates A380, and there's a reason why the Gulf carriers are absolutely killing it with their service, man. And there's also a reason why the European carriers are struggling in terms of competition compared to the Gulf carriers. Now, I don't know whether it's just the German thing or what, but I felt like the staff at Munich Airport and even on the plane, I felt like the service that they provided was kind of bland, you know? They didn't really smile. They weren't really as courteous compared to Emirates and so on and so forth. I just felt like they were just wanting to get their job done and get out of there. Now, obviously, that is my own interpretation of the situation. But if that is the case across the board, then, you know, things need to be changed, man. Things need to be changed real quick. But anyways, let's just talk about the actual journey itself. So I'm not really going to include my short flight from Manchester to Munich. The actual flight that I'm going to be focusing on is the A380 from Munich to Hong Kong. Now, the seating configuration on the A380 is a standard 343, and the seats were comfortable and they were sufficiently wide, but the legroom was something that would leave you desiring something a bit more. But it is economy class, so you can't really expect like the whole plane as your backyard basically. Now, in terms of the entertainment, well, I'm just gonna be honest here, it was shit. I felt like there wasn't enough choices. In terms of the newer films, there were some films that I never even heard of before. Now, I understand that Lufthansa needs to cater to a wide segment of people coming from different areas, but at least have some latest films, man. Like, I was hoping that Lord of the Rings or Too Fast, Too Furious, like films like that would actually be available, but I was left disappointed, so all I did was end up watching Tolkien. But now, that was actually quite good. I was surprised that they would have Tolkien. But that is an area that they could actually improve on. Now, talking about the food, well, I felt like it wasn't really that good, to be honest. Now, I understand that they have to cater to like Muslims as well, and maybe it's just an inconvenience for them, but I felt like what I was eating was just pure plastic. There was no taste to it. And also the options that I was given compared to the person next to me was considerably less. So sometimes I even found myself ordering like the actual normal meal compared to the Muslim meal, just so that I could get the same availability of food compared to them, if you get what I mean. For example, the person next to me ordered a normal meal and they got a yogurt and some jam with their bread, and I was like, where's mine? I didn't get any of that. So after finishing my own meal, I decided to order another one, which was the normal one, just so that I could have an adequate meal. But anyways, I don't know what to say about that, to be honest. It's not really something that they can fix, but I felt like it wasn't really as great as I thought it would be. Now, I said to myself that I will never fly over 10 hours. I have to say, man, that my experience with Lufthansa wasn't the best that I've ever been on. First of all, Lufthansa had no power plugs in economy for larger devices. They only had a USB port. And since we're living in 2019, man, are they actually living in the times that we're in? Now, when I do fly on economy classes, usually with Emirates or Qatar, and they all offer power ports, and considering that Lufthansa doesn't, man, that's a shame, man, because I found myself wanting to charge a few of my devices apart from my phone, and I couldn't, and the only thing that I could charge was my phone. So if there's an area that needs improving, well, that certainly is one. Now, I understand that I may come across as bashing the airline, and to be honest, if that is something that I experienced, then it is what it is. Now, if I had to fly to Hong Kong or some country which is close to that area, then I would actually catch Cathay Pacific, only because they offer non-stop flights. Just the inconvenience of having to stop at Munich, then another 11-hour flight, whereas Cathay Pacific takes 11 hours direct, I think that would be a better option for myself. But in terms of Lufthansa, now that I've experienced it, I know that the hype isn't really justified. But that's just my opinion on that anyways. Maybe it was just one of those days where the service wasn't up to scratch or whatever. I don't know, man. But it is what it is. Now, captains, those are my thoughts. And I want you to share what your thoughts are on Lufthansa. If you've ever flown with the airline, then share your experiences in the comments below and I'll have a read of them. Thank you so much for watching, my friends. Like and subscribe as always. And I hope to catch you guys very soon.